It is the biggest, most electrifying, most exciting drag race of all time. Sit back, relax, because you've got a 60-minute behind-the-scenes VIP pass to the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout, a coveted opportunity for these two-wheeled racers to get in front of a huge crowd. It's the Norwalk Night Under Fire, and I promise you, it'll be a rousing show.
Absolutely incredible. Let's go racing. It is the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Shootout. It's time to get these racers in front of a crowd like they've never experienced before. Let's do it. If you build it, they will come. That's the biggest name in drag racing, John Force. Look at this crowd, ladies and gentlemen. This race, 3 years in the making. It is the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout. What we did here is we told Bill Bader, we're bringing you a freak show. A little Nitro four-cylinder, a little Nitro Harley, a little Nitrous, a little Turbo.
First, let's take you to inside access into the pre-race meeting and give you insight as to why Bill Bader Jr. gets our vote for the greatest drag racing promoter of all time.
At the same time, I woke up this morning with a stomach ache, and I'm still not quite right yet, but this event sold out in its entirety Thursday morning, and there are no tickets, there's no standing room only, there's no general admission. Nobody's getting into this place unless they purchased a ticket in advance, and that is just extraordinary to me, and a testimony to everybody in this room on how excited people are to get back to this racetrack and watch what you men and women do going down this racetrack. So congratulations to all of you. We have also, we are over 800 sportsman cars, which is ridiculous. So if nobody's doing anything tomorrow, we will be eliminating down to winners in five classes tomorrow starting at 9 a.m. Just incredible, an incredible show of support. I appreciate everybody being here. We sell personalities, we tell stories. We ask our fans to get engaged and form a connection with Antron Brown, with Chris Darnell, with Bob Motz, with Don Perdue, with whomever. Tammy Gatlin, right? Glad you finally made it. So we are in the business of connecting you with the men and women in those stands and getting them to, for whatever reason, form a connection on some level. Maybe it has to do with sheer volume of wins. Maybe it has to do with the work you do outside of motorsport. Down the track, if I walk over to you, here's what I want you to assume. So we are in the entertainment business, and we need to remember that, okay? If you take all 4 days of my national event and you add all the people together, there won't be as many people as here tonight. That puts into perspective the difference. We, and I mean no disrespect to my national event, because I'm damn proud of it, but we are here to entertain people. We are the Disney of drag racing, and that's the goal, and we need to remember that all the time. We are here to help you out.
It is Bill Bader Jr.'s birthday. Could we please wish his hand? Let's get this birthday party started. Antron Brown, Brittany Force on a test pass. Cycledrag Universe, that's just a tune-up pass. This place is starting to fill up. Take a look around. Antron Brown, Brittany Force, a sign of what's still to come. And yes, the icon is here, the legend, the 16-time champion, John Force, arguably the greatest of all time. It's a show. John Force with an impressive test hit. He's a rock star. This crowd loves him. 406. Speaking of rock stars, our own Top Fuel motorcycle racers are being treated like rock stars at the autograph signing. This is what it's all about, guys. This is why we did this.
That was the turbo guy.
That was turbo?
We had that?
Yeah. I saw that one from the top.
Guys are rock stars, man.
And guys, this is what it's all about. This is one of the big reasons we wanted to bring the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout to Norwalk. These hardworking racers are being treated like royalty, signing a ton of autographs, fanfare, everything they deserve. This is what they deserve. This is how they deserve to be treated. After all the hard work that they put in, this is unbelievably awesome. They're pretty civil right now, but don't be lulled to sleep, because in this video, we're gonna fight to a finish. Only one can win the biggest race ever.
Scott, your boy is like a rock star over here. I'm worried he's gonna get a hand crab when he signs so many autographs. How
it's
great
awesome.
Is this?
It's awesome. This is just an awesome event.
What a show.
Yes.
Are you telling me the Fist of Power signed so many autographs? He's got cramp.
I'm gonna be able to hold on tonight. I got writer's cramp.
Good luck, bad apple.
And this place is bananas, jam-packed, filling up.
This is nuts. Mitch, I just said I've been to Indy, I've been to the Gator Nationals. I haven't seen a line like this in a long time.
It's awesome. I'm so excited. Whoa. Me and Dave Vantine tried to get somebody to ride our bikes just so we go to the bleachers and watch the show tonight.
And how about, is this the biggest one you've ever seen here?
Yeah, I mean, wow. As a participant, yeah, this one outdoes the ones I did as a participant.
Look at this mob of fans, guys.
I'm so happy for the Bader family. They deserve this turnout. They worked so hard for it. And Bill Jr. had a great mentor.
Ladies and gentlemen, look who I found, Mr. Bill Bader Sr. I gotta say, congratulations. This event, your vision, and I'm hearing this is the biggest ever.
It is.
What does this mean to you? What does this mean to you to watch your vision come this far?
Well, I can tell you, this is a reflection, I think, of being off for a year, the COVID shuttered last year, and a reflection of the enthusiasm people have for racing.
It's amazing. Well, again, you got it. He's busy. Let's let him get back to work, guys. Okay. As you can tell, Tyler, great job, too. I know. How many Night Under Fires have you
been to? This is not racing, but I have been to the Night Under Fire. This is my first one announcing up here.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. You got the best seat in the house up here in Norwalk, guys. It's awesome. Can't even get through. Whoa, who do we have here? What's your name, sir? What's your last name? Wait a minute, you're related to me? Oh, it's so awesome to see you. Who do we have here? Good to see you. And are you guys having fun?
LeSean Norman.
LeSean, the legend, always on our Facebook broadcast. What's your name?
Ed Drake, former Pro Stock Harley racer.
Pro Stock Harley?
Yep.
How about that? He does it all, and he needs Cycledrag decal. Good to see you guys. We're ready to go. We're pumped. Let's get it on.
Let's get you to the pre-race parade, and this may be the coolest visual ever. Eric McKinney right behind John Force.
I think Force wants a piece of you guys.
He wants to run him.
Scott McKinney's been involved in this sport for decades. Eric has certainly paid his dues. It's really fulfilling to see them get in front of the type of crowd they deserve.
We are showcasing motorcycles that is in this year's Park of the Kelley Nitro
about Dennis Bradley smiling ear to ear on the back of that golf cart. He's the owner of Mitch Brown's bike. The Bad Apple. Always a showman. That might be the coolest thing we've ever did in motorcycle drag race. And there they go, guys, from John Force to our very own motorcycle drag racers. That is awesome.
Phone call was overwhelming. How's it feel to finally be here?
It's amazing, Bill. Thanks for everybody.
Cycledrag Universe, this is truly amazing. Take a look at this house. We haven't even started the show yet. What an opportunity for these Pingel Top Fuel Motorcycle racers.
And when you're short-staffed, like we're short-staffed, to watch these men and women come to your aid, and to watch them that we're safe here in the United States of America. You know, I see so much more. The ones who do that,
this place is packed,
food and beverage, merchandise, the Air Force and Marines, have paid the promise bearing. The Air Force is also the largest. The U.S. Army was founded 14 June.
On Jersey by
Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Shootout. Antron came from motorcycles. He had mentors like Dave Schultz, Paul Gast. He's one of us, guys. Congratulations, AB. We're about to put 8 of the baddest motorcycles in front of the biggest crowd ever, and you got a front row seat. Let's go. And you're not gonna believe how things shook out. Let's take a look at our first round pairings. And our first matchup features our Nitrous bikes. Eric McKinney qualified number 4. The only bad news for him is in the opening round, he's got to run his teammate, Ashley Owens, also on a Nitrous Oxide GS. Ashley, the first man to put one of these things in the threes. The good news for the team is they know a Nitrous bike is going to round 2. And this is what's so great about the unpredictability of this race, guys. You never know what's going to happen. We bring in Dave Vantine. He's the 4th quickest ever. On paper, he's the quickest here. But guess what? Getting 1,500 horsepower to hook up when you haven't had much testing this year is very hard to do. Because of that, Vantine qualified last, number 8.
It's certainly not where the team thought they would end up, but it only takes one hit to figure it out. They've smoked the tire twice.
And guess who Vantine will take on in round number one? A man who's been attracting all types of attention, coming off his 6:05 in Maryland a few weeks ago. It is the evil one, Bill Vose, the first man to put a pro mod in the sixes. He came here, he qualified number one. It could be history in the making because we've never put a turbo bike in the 5 second zone. We are so close. Remember, we had a last minute cancellation of the Spider-Man Larry McBride when he needed emergency knee surgery. We got Bill Vose to step up and fill in, and he has done an amazing job. He's your number one qualifier, but he's got to tangle with Vantine in round one. We've got Sam Wills, the veteran out of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. He struggled to get down the racetrack. He will take on the number two qualifier, Nitro Harley, the snake, Stordeur. The bad apple of Tracy Kile qualifies in the number three spot, Nitro Harleys, taking the top two spots. He will take on Mitch Brown and the monster Top Fuel Motorcycle. All right, motorcycle racers, time to shine. The opportunity of a lifetime is now. We are locked, an incredible teammate battle. Ashley pulling away, top of the racetrack. Ashley, 6:39. Ashley going on.
6:39, 192. That is the quickest a pro mod has gone in about a decade. Wow, Ayo going to round two.
Now it's Harley versus four-cylinder as defending Man Cup champ Mitch Brown takes on the bad apple, Tracy Kile. Tracy has 6:20 potential.
Takes out a 660. Mitch stepped up when he needed to, pulled that rabbit out of his mouth. Mitch Brown going to round two.
Sam's one of the fastest here, but he only got one qualifying hit. That could hurt him. Here comes hometown boy Jake the Snake Stordeur. He got a hold of me and he said, this is my dream to run this event. Please invite me. I said, Jake, you earned it. Let's see what he can do in front of his fellow Ohioan crowd. Dead even, locked, wheel to wheel, bar to bar, down through the stripe, wind light coming on a whole shot. Jake Stordeur.
Jake the Snake on a whole shot. On a whole shot. 649 takes out a 646 on a whole shot.
Making sure we don't have one in the sand, guys. Making sure we don't have one in the sand.
As Sam Wills, I believe, went into the sand trap. So we are, and I, the NHRA Safety Safari is down there, and everybody is A-okay.
Well, guys, thoughts and prayers to Sam Wills right now. Nobody saw the parachute. We saw a whiff of sand.
I don't want to bore you with all of the ridiculous numbers of drag racing. But
wow, on a whole shot,
thing.
Jake Stordeur gets the win. We're hearing Sam is okay.
Was 16 one-thousandths of a second.
All right, great news, guys. The best news. Sam is out of the sand trap. The bike is out. His crew was saying he didn't see a parachute. Parachute didn't come out. But the good news is Sam is okay. An uneasy moment. Thank goodness Sam's okay. Hey, bracket racers, check this out. 16 ten-thousandths of a second. Woo! That was a bracket race. Probably this close down there, this close. We've still got one pair left to go. And that brings us to a mega matchup that is final worthy, but the way qualifying works, it's going to happen in round one. The Evil One, Billy Vose, number one qualifier, he went 617 on the turbo bike. He will take on the fourth quickest man in the world. Dave Vantine's been a 570, but has struggled to get down the racetrack here this weekend. Can Team Pollard, can Team Nitro Joe, can Team Vantine hit that tune-up, or will Billy Vose reign supreme?
So the word from Top End is they are removing that motorcycle.
And did you see that? That's what it's all about, folks. Billy Vose has dedicated his life to this sport. To see him introduced in front of 40,000 along with Dave Vantine is something special. And you know, as we get into racing, certainly stopping is on these racers' minds. Matt Smith, after he won here at the NHRA race, he actually called out Norwalk on national TV, said we need a little bit more room. I spoke with Bill Bader. Bill Bader showed me the footage. He said, hey, we have enough feet to stop safely. We have more than Pomona. The problem talking to Larry Spiderman McBride is there's just a little bit of an optical illusion down there, and it looks like you have a little bit more than what you do. That's on all these racers' minds right now. So thank goodness Sammy's okay, certainly stopping, something both these racers are thinking about. Dave's got the possibility to go 260 miles an hour. That's a very fast motorcycle. Let's hope his parachute comes out. And after qualifying last, Vantine knows he needs a Cinderella-esque upset to advance. All of a sudden, we've got a turbo versus nitro showdown here in round number one, a packed house, everything we thought it would be. It is the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout. So happy to put these great racers in front of this crowd. This is what they deserve. The entire field, Dave Vantine, Billy Vose. You know, Billy Vose, the first one to put a pro mod in the 6 second zone back in 1997. He is a legend. What an opportunity for him. He's been 617. They changed engines last night. But boy, does he have a tough draw and a tough customer, because Dave Vantine has 570 potential. They just have not been able to make it down the racetrack cleanly, and that's why Vantine qualified in the number 8 hole. Billy with the whole shot, but something goes away. Here comes the yellow bullet out the back door. Dave Vantine, 596.
Whoa! Whoa, what an upset. Hey, where's Nitro Joe? Where's Nitro Joe? Where's Mr. Polar? Oh my goodness! Wow! What a time to step up!
Yes, yeah, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Where'd that tune-up come from?
Out of the cooler, I told you.
Out of the cooler, you're right! Where did that tune-up come from? Greg, talking about stepping up when you needed to. Congratulations, what an upset, guys. Big congratulations to the Evil on Billy Vose. Look at the yellow shirts. Get it done. The yellow shirts going on. Unbelievable, guys. We're just getting started. Share this video. It's the Cycledrag Pingel Night Under Fire Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout. Dave Vantine. Stella's got her groove back. But congratulations, Billy had a great weekend. I think the turbos are headed for the fives real soon.
Let's get you some inside updates from the pits.
I've been to a lot of drag races. I've never seen it packed like this. This is amazing. You can barely walk in here.
And unfortunately, it was a rough night for the Donk Master. Thankfully, he's okay. Hey, as long as the stereo still works, we're in good shape.
Someone just yelled to the Donk Master, it'll rub out. I don't think that one will bump out. Thankfully, he's okay, but a rough night for the Donks.
Do it because I love it, that's all.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, there he is, arguably the most famous and successful drag racer of all time, the one and only John Force. Mr. Force, I know you're so busy. What keeps you coming back to the Night Under Fire?
Well, I love to race, always have, but Bill Bader puts on the greatest show on earth. He's the P.T. Barnum of drag racing. And the fans love him. He packed it in tonight. This is the biggest crowd I ever saw here.
Can you believe this turnout? I mean, it's hard to move around here.
Yeah, and the money he spends on fireworks show, he gives the fans the real show.
For the first time ever, we brought in an 8-motorcycle shootout. We've got Top Fuel bikes here, Nitro Harleys. What do you think about those guys?
I was out there watching. I even went up in the stands to watch that one guy take a lift.
Thanks so much, guys. He's the legend, John Force.
How cool is that? John Force is watching. We've got a mess down in Sam Will's pit. Let's check in with him. The good news is he's okay.
The legend, Sam Wills, you stopped our hearts for a second. We didn't see a parachute. What happened down there?
I had the parachute out.
The parachute did come out.
Absolutely.
Somebody was saying the chute didn't come out.
I just ran the bike a little bit past the finish line because I thought I could catch it. And I missed by 16 thousandths.
How close was that down there?
Oh, I thought I got mine. I really did.
I mean, what do you think? Maybe we're talking about a couple inches? Wow. So
whatever 16 10,000s equates to at 211 miles an hour. So.
One of the closest races we've ever seen in Top Fuel. Let's take you back. This one was worth the price of admission. Sam Leflane on the Top Fuel motorcycle, 4-cylinder machine, dancing around, but undeterred is Jake the Snake. He stays in it on his Nitro Harley. Look at how close it is. Sam sputtering down there at the top end by 16 thousandths. Jake the Snake gets him. Sam late on the brakes, late on the parachute. There it is. But unfortunately, Sam goes into the sand trap.
So how deep did you go into the sand?
I went all the way through the sand, almost to the grass again. My rear brake didn't work. Rear brake had pedal, but it didn't work. It didn't stop.
What do you attribute that to?
I'll let you know after I get delved into it. Right now, we're just trying to clean the rocks off of it and assess what's damaged. I know the blower's full of dust and dirt, but I don't know if it got any pebbles. It tore the front cowling up pretty good. That's deep. A lot deeper than I thought it was. I was trapped on the bike because my foot was still on the peg and it was deeper than the peg. So they had to come and turn, get the bike going the opposite direction so I could get my foot out from under the rocks.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's amazing you were able to scrub that much speed with the front brake and the parachute.
Yeah.
No rear brake, that's impressive. Wow. What were you thinking as you were going in? I mean, I know you're such a veteran, you know how to prepare for stuff
like this. I just made sure I let go of the front brake, made sure I kept it straight. And it went straight and come to a stop. You know, the safety equipment did its job. It was a, you know, it's hell on your parts, but it did its job.
Most important thing, absolutely no injuries to you?
No.
Perfect. So glad you're okay, man. Sorry things didn't shake out, but
hey,
that's racing,
it's
right?
Racing.
He's okay. Thank goodness. He scared us. He's okay. Of lesser importance, the motorcycle is not. It needs some deep cleaning everywhere. Oh. Sam, I believe sand and high performance engines do not mix, do they?
Oh, no. We mix great. It's me and dirt that don't mix.
Oh.
Look at the plugs.
Huh?
Look at the plugs. Best plugs we've had.
Had a little furry there where it pulled the, but yeah.
2 pounds of heat.
No destruction. Now, here's the one thing, I don't want any rocks.
So unfortunately, it's a rear brake failure. Sam will be upgrading to the carbon setup Larry McBride likes. The parachute did come out, but it was too late. We're hearing Jake has problems. Guys, and we got bad news. Jake the Snake with a big win. But Jake, what happened here?
Broken jack shaft.
Broken jack shaft. Oh, that's going to end your weekend?
Yep.
You got to be happy with what you were able to do here, though.
Yeah,
qualified number two, beat Sam Wills by what? That must have been inches down there?
It wasn't very far.
Oh.
0.016 was the margin of victory.
Sorry about your luck.
It's what it is, it's drag racing.
Ashley Owens still in, ready to go. It was a mega matchup in round one, Evil One Bill Vose. I said that was worthy of a final, the way qualifying happened. You were number one. Dave Vantine, who's the quickest on paper, was number eight. A huge showdown. What happened to you there first round?
Well, it's funny because going into it, I told Dave, I said, you were the last guy who won the race. And Dave told me that, you know, you're the last guy who won the race. And we laughed about it. And I said, you know, somehow over the years, when it was really important, you always had that golden horseshoe on me. And, well, just kind of like followed through, you know, just like every once in a while, you just got that one guy, you know, that can just pull it out. Dave's awesome. I love Dave. I've been running for him for years. And I'm going along, and I'm like, yeah, I got him. And the next thing you know, I lost power. The last night, a lot of damage to the exhaust wheel and the turbo, and I guess it disintegrated from the harmonics and the out of balance, and so I lost all boost, and then he drove by me, and that's racing, you know. Should've, would've, could've, didn't, whatever the stakes is, but we'll be back, and this bike's a beast.
It sure is. You guys put on one heck of a show, and nobody can take it away from you. You were number one qualifier this weekend. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And this exhilarating show rolls on. Our three remaining competitors must turn those motorcycles around quickly because they will be called up in a short period of time. How about 300 miles an hour, Cycledrag? How about this crowd?
Yeah.
These guys are loving it. They're loving it at Cycledrag.
Nobody is more disappointed.
Hey, yeah. You guys are having a good time. You guys are having a good time. There it is. There it is.
So we will try
to Ashley. Is it the day of Team Nitrous?
We'll have to see.
So guys, with the breakage to Jake Stordeur, Mitch Brown is going on to the final. We're going to have to start calling Mitch Brown the upset kid. This Pingel race is all we thought it would be. Even beyond the quarter mile, we are packed, ladies and gentlemen. How about every inch of real estate they have here at Summit Motorsports Park is taken up. Team Nitrous working quickly. Hey 869, 179 miles an hour. I could probably almost beat him on my Hayabusa, but the fans love it. Tells you something. Not all about the numbers, is it? It's about the show. He's packing the parachute. We got to call him the comeback underdog kid because, again, Mitch, you're going to the final here. Jake Stordeur breaks.
Yeah, I know. I mean, same with that race with Tracy. It was a really close race. Seems like a lot of times we get cards in our favor, but, you know, we always try to play it conservative the best that we can, and it seems to work out for us. So
you got some good mojo. I heard you say you might just run on alcohol this pass.
Just to warm it up.
Okay.
Just to warm it up because they came and said we need to get going. So we'll probably just put a little heat on alcohol and it'll be fine. And we'll take it up there and ready to go. Having lots of fun.
Good luck. Mitch Brown, what's going on? Well, I got to get my homeboy some ice cream here as we get ready for the semifinals. Pound of ice cream for a dollar. How amazing is that? That's Norwalk for you. Three moose tracks, here we go. How about that? That is so awesome.
Young lady, I'm sorry, are your arms getting sore? You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Great job all day long. Thank you very much to you as well.
There it is. Let's go make Kyle and Warren very, very happy. They're working hard for Cycledrag. Ice cream makes everybody smile. Let's go cheer them up. Much deserved.
Thank you.
Welcome
very
to Norwalk,
much.
Kyle.
Wow,
you having a good
pound
time?
Of ice cream.
It is hot ice cream. That'll fill you up. That's dinner. There you go. For now.
Wow.
Hardest working photog in the business. He's taking a little break, and your break's about to get a little sweeter, my friend. Enjoy. You got to have ice cream in Norwalk.
We did all right.
Motorcycles coming up, but first it is time for perennial showstopper Bob Motz and his jet truck.
Guys, I've never seen a drag race this packed. Never. I've been to some good Gator Nationals, some good U.S. Nationals. Take a look at this.
He's shutting that truck down. Something's not right here. And it's a live show and risk is involved. Anything can happen. Bob is okay, he's out of the truck, and that is what's most important. That's wild, guys. That's not the way they planned it, but when you get towed out and you still get a standing ovation, I think it's safe to say you're over. I think it's safe to say you did it right and you won these fans' attention and appeal. Congratulations, I'm glad he's okay. Bob Motz.
Trying to get you some updates. So again, we are going to take an intermission. Give us a few minutes to regroup and we'll be right back.
Oh gosh. Now the fiasco with Bob Motz's jet truck just left a mess on the racetrack. It's gonna take a long time to clean up.
This is going to give the Top Fuel Motorcycle racers a lot more time.
Hey, stay off the racetrack, off the return road. Everybody back away. Let us run our equipment.
We got all the top photogs in the house. What's your name, sir?
My name's David Gates.
I love it.
It's incredibly difficult to clean up that mess, but Bill Bader is well-staffed. He's got a crew, and they're going to get it done in a timely fashion.
So here's the situation, guys. We still got track cleanup. Dave Vantine has opted to switch lanes. Vantine is going to put Ashley Owens in this lane. Ashley basically said, I'm not worried. I know this is a Kurt Johnson racetrack, and this lane will be perfect. We'll see, though. We'll see what John Force thinks. He loves watching the motorcycle.
Oh no, and a last minute scramble here over in Vantine's pits.
It's sitting here to change pulleys?
Pardon me?
They decided while sitting here to change pulleys?
Yeah. Kind of a last minute thought. They just, we don't want to light the tire right from the get go.
Are they doing anything?
No,
only on the right.
I really hope they do something early.
As conditions change, you're always making adjustments to the motorcycle, especially in Top Fuel.
You are dressed well, my friend.
Thank you.
And there's Team Ashley Owens looking for what would be the upset of his career. We are about set. This is it. A trip to the final is what is at stake in front of this huge, record-breaking crowd. It's Nitrous versus Nitro.
John Force's guy gave him advice. AO is going to the final. Guys, that's the unpredictable nature of drag racing. We told you this was going to be a wild race. The Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout. Mitch Brown will go to the final to face AO. Can he run better than 640 for lane choice? Let's find out.
Squirt bottle went dead where they're sitting there waiting.
And there is tuner and pro mod driver Todd Martin. He owns Tulsa Raceway Park. This team working on their brand new fuel tech setup. It's groundbreaking for Top Fuel Motorcycle. Mitch going to the final. Congratulations, Mitch. We got a final coming up, but I think I saw a little flicker in this jam-packed crowd. Uh-oh.
Holy moly, guys. The power just went out at the Night Under Fire. We thought it was just in the media suite. No, the Christmas tree is out. We got lights down there, but Norwalk, Summit Motorsports Park just lost everything. We don't hear the announcer anymore. This is insane. Oh man, I feel so bad for Bill. He's probably freaking out. He's got 40,000 fans here and no power. This is wild. The power is out, guys. Unbelievable. Well, we do have lights down there, about half track, but nothing else.
Really, dude?
Guys, it's definitely not part of the show. Power is out. We have no announcements.
But we're still partying up in the media center with Kubota.
They are still partying, that's for sure. It may not stop the party, but certainly an unenviable situation right now for the folks at Summit Motorsports Park. This event was just going so smoothly. 40,000 plus rowdy fans and no power. There's only one way to fix this. Unleash a fireworks display like they've never seen before. Guys, this is crazy. The power is still out. They decided to go ahead with the fireworks show. As you can see, that's one way to entertain this captive audience. I'm not so sure, though, if we're gonna be able to continue this event. Still waiting to see if we can get power back here at Summit Motorsports Park. All the fans loved it. Well done, Summit Motorsports Park. But it's official. We're done for the night. We got no power. The track walk is on. What does this mean for our Top Fuel shootout?
Well, guys, we're thinking about arm wrestling for the final spot. We're down. Uh-oh. We're down to the final. They were going to arm wrestle. They were going to split. But guess what? These men are going to wait till tomorrow after this crazy, weird occurrence, guys. The power goes out.
That's crazy.
That's crazy. But we're going to run it indeed. We're going to run it tomorrow.
All
right, we got to hold them back. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hold on, hold on. This is it. Our final tomorrow. Nitrous, Nitro. Who's going to win, guys?
I'm going to try my best. I know Ashley doesn't have nothing in him but try his best.
Yep.
Well, honestly, conditions are probably going to be totally different, right?
I don't know, it could be similar because it'll be a little cool like it is in the evening, but I haven't really looked at the weather, so I don't know. What do you think, Ace?
I don't know.
Well,
we thought not good at predictions, we'll see what happens.
It's awesome, guys. I'll tell you, we thought the Pingel Cycledrag Top Fuel Motorcycle Shootout Eliminator was going to be one day. It's going to be two. Let's go to Sunday.
All right, everybody got a little sleep, and as Bill Bader said in the beginning of this video, he's got 800 sportsmen to run today and a Top Fuel motorcycle final.
Welcome to Sunday, Cycledrag Universe. Track looks a little different, doesn't it?
Just a little bit.
Oh my gosh, do you guys smell that? Oh. That's heavenly. That's unfair. It's 9:30 in the morning. That is maybe one of the best smells in the world. Onions, peppers, cheesesteaks, and sausages. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry, guys. I need a minute. That smells too good. I hope it's coming through your smartphone. How are you, sir?
Oh,
man, you're killing me with these smells. I think I want one for breakfast. Is it too early?
Just a little bit.
Until what? 10 o'clock. All right, we'll wait till 10. Good job, guys. Who do we have here?
Brandon.
Where are you from?
Cleveland.
Thank you so much. You just stopped me and said you watched me on Facebook.
Absolutely, all the time.
Thanks for watching the motorcycles, my man. If I had any more stickers, I'd give you some, but they cleaned me out.
It's all right.
Thanks a lot for watching.
No problem, man. It's a race.
But we are set for our Top Fuel Motorcycle Final. I give the guys a lot of credit. They could have split last night. They're both racers. They said, no, we want to finish this thing. Let's get it in. Let's crown a winner. And you've got a front row seat. Let me know where you are watching from down in the comments. And if you love this class, here we go. It's final time. Elimination started yesterday. It's brought us to one exciting culmination. It is Nitro versus Nitrous. We talked about the horseshoe. Mitch was done. Ashley crosses the center line. You guys are the champs. How in the world? I'll tell you what. Mitch has got some horseshoe, some clover over there.
Look at ours, man.
Unbelievable, guys. Congratulations. Wow.
It's been said, luck is when preparedness meets opportunity. Mitch was there. Ashley, way out in front, he had this thing won, but right here he gets into problems. Remember, Pro Mod not used to running quarter mile. He can't bring it back. He doesn't know how close Mitch is. Mitch wins.
Sam, describe what that is to our viewers at home, please.
It drives the fuel pump and the oil pump.
Sam, have you ever seen anybody with a bigger horseshoe? Hey, God bless them, no disrespect.
That's part of racing.
That's
luck.
Part of racing. The Nitro God's smiling.
Let's talk to our winner.
Well, big congratulations to our winner, Mitch.
What do you got there?
You left a souvenir on the track. I told you, I'll say it again. You guys work hard, but I think the racing gods are obviously smiling down on you, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
We never see AO cross.
Yeah, I know it, but you know, they haven't raced quarter mile for a long time, you know, and Ashley told me that he chunked a tire last time for the first time in forever, but they're not used to going that quarter mile. I think it's just different, and it's, you know, tires getting hotter, bike's probably a little harder to handle, but yeah, I was surprised when I saw him wiggling and he was fighting it, you know.
Big win for Mitch. Mitch, who do you want to thank?
You know, obviously I want to thank Bill Bader and you for putting this on, and Wayne and Donna Pingel for helping it out. Definitely all of our crew, John Jenkins, Scott Smith, Eddie Rushing, Dennis, Dustin Warner, Todd Martin, and then Danielle and Clint Myers that you met over in Australia for the Foursquare. They're a big supporter of us. MTC, David Ligori, I keep mentioning, but that dude's an awesome guy. He really helped us out a lot. And everybody that helps. We get a lot of little help from people with cards and taking over and stuff, and that really helps us. So thank you, thank you, thank you for that. Couldn't do it any other way.
Congratulations, Mitch. We said it once, we'll say it again, guys. Never give up. Never give
up. That's right. That's my lucky charm. That's the one that came off at Valdosta when we went to the final. If it comes off, we're going to the final.
This is the one you thought was a squirrel.
Yep, that's the squirrel.
We saw it on Cycledrag. We love it. There must be some good mojo, some good luck. I'm going to touch it just for, it's like touching the bull on Wall Street.
That's right.
Congratulations. Mitch Brown gets it done.
How matters? How's that go? Better? Rather lucky than good?
Yeah, I know. Am I lucky? See, you're next. Remember, I blew the blower fully off, and then you had yours come off, so tighten up your shit.
Let's try to catch up with Owens.
Ashley, very sorry. We talk about how we never see you cross the center line. Very tough. What happened out there?
Not sure. We had to put a new tire on last night. Maybe a little different. Just kind of started driving left. Maybe I stayed with it a little bit too long. And just trying to get down through there. And just disappointed. You know how it is.
Well, you got to leave here with your head.
head up high because a nitrous bike going to the finals, very impressive. You had it to win. And what I was driving home too is when you're in the zone, you didn't really know Mitch was that far behind, right? You thought Mitch could come up at any point.
Yeah.
So you have to stay full send.
Yeah, we stayed in a little bit too long, like I said, because I thought he'd be coming up. Then I don't want to get over in his lane or get next to him. So once it got over, I could tell he was back there. But I just disappointed, you know. Just disappointed in the weekend.
It's going to stink for a little while, but overall, congratulations. Yeah. Go home knowing that a nitrous bike could have won it all and is leaving with a runner-up. Congratulations.
Thanks, man.
One more look at why you never give up. What do you think went wrong here? Let us know in the comments and make sure to give this video a share. Thanks for watching. Congratulations, Mitch.
What an event it was, guys. 3 years in the making. Thank you, Bill Bader and family. Thank you, Pingel. Check it out. The ice cream line. Still packed. You guys ready for some ice cream, huh?
Amen!
We're ready for some ice cream. And the fans absolutely love the motorcycles. Let's hope we can do it again. Share this video. Thanks so much for watching. If you like that video, here's another one for you. Hit subscribe right in the middle. And you know, if there's anything fast motorcycles involved, we're in Cycledrag. Rolls on.